Hi guys, so I'm shooting another video, but I realized that my computer didn't want to, this didn't want to work, so right now I'm filming on my phone, because, yeah. So I'm gonna move off this little way. Get it out of the way. Okay, so, crap, I need to find something to film on. Like to prop this up some. Did that work? Let me flip you guys around. Quick. Well, I think that actually might work there. And then, no longer I get to it. Ooh, I can turn this to face you guys. Let me grab this real quick. Put that back. I'm gonna use this as my little mouse pad piece. So, yeah. You guys see me? There I am. So, we're gonna go to Google. And yeah, I actually wonder if that will work. Will that work? Oh yeah. Okay. Amazon. Is out. Okay. Let's see. I know, my computer is very slow. Okay, so we want to look for. There he is. Let's see what Google can provide us with. Ooh, there's a WR120. Oh no, is this the B? Oh no, this is the normal one. Put that to a cart. Hey, two radios that I already got. Nice. Just so you know, they really are really good radios. I mean, they are the best. This is a HH50B, which is very, very similar to its predecessor. Well, not predecessor, but this. This is one of Midland's handheld radios. Excuse me. But yeah, this is one of Midland's handheld walkie-talkies. And yeah. I keep it over here, as you guys, know. I'll show you in just a minute, but we're gonna add this to my cart. Just cuz. It's a very pretty radio. I like it. You can see, like right there, you can test it or rescan volume up and down. That may be all the things it has. Let's look at this video. See, I haven't been on this computer in forever.
Enough to fit in your purse, in your pocket, in your golf bag, in your tackle box. You can take it anywhere you like, and it'll give you instant access to the weather forecast, and it will automatically alert you during severe weather. It runs on three AAA batteries. It's the Midland HH50 handheld weather alert radio.
Here's another one. I wonder what this one is. R RA365.
This is the Midland HH50 handheld weather radio. It's small enough to fit in your purse, in your pocket, in your golf bag, in your tackle box.
I'm dumb. That's the exact same video, but there again, they're dumb for posing it twice. Making me look like the idiot. But, I mean, there's some really good radios here. Let's see. Let's go look for some other ones. Let's see. I'm tired of these stupid little crank radios. I don't need them. I don't need a crank radio. I'm fine with the radios I have. I have seen this. This kinda looks cool, but I'm not gonna spend $50 on a gimmicky radio. I've actually thought about getting this radio. I've thought about it. The R210 and this one as well. I have really thought about it, but I don't really feel too good about it. I'm glad that it has that little battery meter right there. Right there? Yeah, I'm glad that it has that. But we're gonna go back a few pages. Back to this crap hit my knee. I'm not seeing anything too interesting. Ooh, I've kind of thought about getting this, the lacrosse technology one. I think it's kind of cool. It's just so gimmicky. I mean, those hurricanes. The only thing bad that I see about the Midland ER210 and the ER310 is, like, doesn't it take batteries though? Because I would have to guess so, because then you just have to spend hours cranking it up just to get it to have a little bit of a charge. Wait, that one's also pretty cool right here. The one with the highlighted letters. Yeah, this one right here. It's pretty cool. For those of you who are wondering, this is actually my family's computer that we used to have. And we got a new one because I needed a new one for schoolwork. Because this one was just too slow at the time. And so my mom and dad had them fix it where it runs a little bit quicker. Because this is a 2008 computer. Living in 2020. I just want to kind of look around on Amazon and just kind of see what we got. Oh, I do have to admit, that is kind of cool. It's got like an SOS light on it, so that's pretty cool. But honestly, ICE radio, I could look at the weather radios like Midland WR120 for hours. And I don't know what that is. Little radios like this, like they're reskinned and all that. I mean, not like a reskin, but like the insides are a little bit different. But pretty much they look the exact same. And I've seen stuff like that. And I don't really trust some of the things that are coming out of China now. Not that I don't trust China. I don't have anything against China. It's just that they're so far away, and I mean, no offense, but some of the stuff that I've gotten from there, no, I'm not saying that all the things that they have are horrible, but, you know, most of it I'm not a real big fan of, because it breaks really easily, and so I don't mean any offense to them. Just some of the things that they make are just kind of cheap in a way. I mean, even some of the people in China have to admit that. Because I've gotten a ton of things like this, and they're made in China. And so I can say this with proof. I've had stuff like this. Like that little crank grater right there. I've had something really similar to that, and it just busted on the second day. I didn't drop it, I didn't nothing. It just broke. So, I don't really have a whole lot of trust in stuff like that. Like I said, not that I have anything against them, just they're so far away and some of the stuff that they make isn't all the best. Running Snail is actually a very, very good company. They're not too bad. Not that I'd buy anything from them, but I'm just saying they are. Pretty good. Let's see. Let's see, where's the dash? I haven't used this computer in years. R dash. Yeah, the R-1630 I've heard is a very good radio. What's that? Boop boop doo. But I mean, there's this radio that I kind of want to get. USB. It's just asking you to charge it. I didn't ask you to recognize it. Is going to be here in a few days. I don't know exactly how many days, but Amazon's saying that it should be here either the 14th or the 20th, so I'll have to do an unboxing on that. Right now I'm just trying to do content. Now, I really want this radio right here, but here's the only thing I see wrong with it. It is $140. I'm not spending $140 just for something to break. It's got 4 stars, so if I buy it, I just have money to blow. I think. But just something with 4 stars I don't feel too comfortable with. No, it may just be because people don't know how to use them, but I just don't feel too good about that. I wonder if there is an Eton Zone Guard in here. I've heard that they stopped selling them, but Eton Zone Guard. This is the Zone Guard Plus. This is Zone Guard Plus. Okay, I don't want movies. There it is. Maybe one day I do want to get a Eton Zone Guard. I've heard that they're very nice radios. What do we have here? Well, I mean, if I buy a radio, I would love to buy it brand new. I'd like to buy it new, but a lot of times you can't, and a lot of times you can. So I like to get new radios when I can. Radio 12-262. I wonder if they actually do have a 262. I doubt it. They probably have cables for the Radio Shack 262, but I doubt that they actually have the 262. Oh, they have its cousin. It's very similar. Oh, what is this radio? It has a lot of things in common with the 12262, but it's not. Let's see. This is a... It does not say. I guess it is a 12262. I like it. It looks really nice. I've seen it a little bit on Amazon. This is what I mean by, like, sometimes you have to buy it used. Okay, do not fall for this scam, okay? I have gotten a radio from here. And, you know, it looks all good at first. I got this thing for $10, okay? So, like, if you see this on Amazon, do not buy it, because I have bought something like this, I bought this exact one, and so whenever I bought it, I got it for about $10, and pretty much what happened is he or she left batteries inside. And so they leaked everywhere. And the screen. Okay, so it is this one. And pretty much what happened is he left batteries in the battery compartment. And they got all corroded and stuff. And then the screen of it, right here, it came off. Now, I'm not saying that it's the fault of whoever's selling it. But, you can see, like, where I had to glue it. Let me grab my little light so you guys can see this. It is ridiculous, because we had to take some glue and put it on it, just so that way the screen would stay on. And you can see up there where, like, there's glue residue. So, I mean, this is not the radio that I bought, but I'm willing to live with it because he partially gave me what I wanted, but it doesn't have the cord. They did not give me the cord, and they just don't buy this, okay? You will waste your $10 when you could have got something a lot nicer. So, just as a quick warning, you can get it if you want it, but I suggest you don't, because you're just going to end up wasting your money when you could save it and get something better. So, what if you do? Do not fall for this scam. I'm just glad that they gave it to me. So they will give you what you get. You will get what you asked for. But it's not really the same radio that's in the picture. I think the radio that's in the picture is like a version 1, maybe. But that just kind of makes me a little bit upset. They scam people like that. It kind of makes me mad. So, there's one more radio that I was wanting to get, so I'm gonna send you guys right there real quick while I look for it. I can't exactly remember, so that's kind of why I need to look real quick and see which one it was. Ah, the Radio Shack 12522. So 12522 is the one that I was wanting to get. It's that little handheld radio. So let's look for the radio. I mean, they still sell a few Radio Shack stuff, but I mean, boy, is it expensive. See, that has 5 stars, so I'm not kind of freaked out about it. And it's brand new, so I have no doubt that they're going to get it to me, so, yeah. I think that is the end of this video. I hope that you guys enjoyed watching. And yeah, I'll see you guys all in the next video where we will be, I'll end the video over here so that we can kind of get my camera all set up and adjusted. But yeah, tomorrow is Weekly Test Wednesday. Can't forget about Weekly Test Sunday, but tomorrow's not Weekly Test Sunday. Tomorrow is Weekly Test Wednesday. So, yeah, we're gonna, get everything all set up for Weekly Test Wednesday tomorrow. So, this is the camera view that you guys will see tomorrow. I'm just gonna straighten this out. So that way it's a little bit easier to get it. And, yeah. I guess that's gonna end this video. I hope that you guys enjoyed the video. Good lord. In 22 minutes. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.